Tell us a little bit about what type of anesthesia that you like for your surgery.
So the anesthesia that I would insist on my patients would be what's known as an interscalene block. That's not important. What's important is the nerves that go to the shoulder have been blocked for surgery. And I like to use a longer acting pain medication.
And by block you mean they're numbed up?
They're numbed up. So, for example, my patients will not even know they've had surgery for 2 to 3 days after surgery because the numbing medicine is continuing to keep the shoulder pain free, and that's a very critical time because that's when the patient has a bad experience. That's when the start of a bad experience, like you said.
And not every surgeon uses those techniques,
correct,
by the way.
If I was to, and again, I'm old enough to tell you that I've used this anesthesia now. I've also seen when this was not around. The moment the patient woke up and opened their eyes, they had pain. Mm-hmm. And that's, nobody wants that.
No.
Today, patients, the first question out of their mouth is, what? Are you telling me I'm in the recovery room already? I don't trust you.
Right, that's very common.
So,
the sensation of pain is literally non-existent in our recovery rooms,
correct,
from the surgeries that we do.
You mentioned intubate, and a lot of people watching might not know what that is. In other words, you don't have general anesthesia, and a lot of people
are
really scared of that.
You're not getting a tube in your throat breathing for you.
Because of nausea and
right,
after effects. So this, you're able to isolate,
right,
the area, and then the twilight is like general relaxing.
Your eyes are closed. You don't know what's going on. You can't respond to something, to a question that's asked of you, and we wouldn't try to ask you a question.
Mm-hmm.
You're functionally in a light sleep. And
it's
we
like
do that.
A GI procedure, for example.
A colonoscopy or something like that. It's very, very comfortable. And some people are in fear of waking up during my surgery.
Right.
Just doesn't happen.
Just doesn't happen.
And you also keep their pain under control after. I mean, not with opioids and whatnot, but you give them injections and you keep it such,
correct,
that they're,
correct,
not hurt.
Right.
Yeah, we've figured out over time what works and what gives the least side effect.
Uh-huh.
Narcotics is not the way to go anymore. You don't have to get constipations and nauseas and vomitings and all the side effects of all the strong pain medicine. We can bypass that through other means. For example, the numbing of the nerve we talked about. Simple things like Tylenol, something mm-hmm. simple like an injection after surgery. Mm-hmm. Both me and Dr. Perlmutter believe in doing stem cells and platelet-rich plasmas, things that heal your surgery faster.
Mm-hmm.
And stimulate healing more.
Stimulate healing, get to that pain-free level faster. So we're not, if this is the problem, call it whatever, we're attacking it from every angle we can find. Mm-hmm. So we do less of everything else and get that multimodal pain initiation onto that shoulder, onto that wrist, onto that back.